Hey everybody, welcome back to another exciting episode of the Extreme Hardcore Nerds Present Roll for Initiative. Now, if you happen to remember last week, we had to cut our episode 8 in half because it went a little longer than expected, and I know you've been sitting on pins and needles to find out what happened to our heroes as they entered into this new array of challenges, shall we say. So, await no longer as, once again, we roll for initiative.
In a land where stories and fables are told, a band of skilled and brave misfits have joined forces to protect the realm from evil. Sit back as we tell you of their tale. Prepare yourself as we roll for initiative.
Going down to the slums, where we drop the head of that thing that regenerates and pass the giant.
Right. The corpse of the giant.
You guys go down to a slum district called Casted Light, and in that area is a pathway that leads down to the jungle floor. Some of the people that live in the slums take this place to go get food, because as much as the jungle produces these mutated monsters and stuff, they have produced a lot of mutated trees that provide vast amounts of food. So as much as they're poor down here, they're not starving if they're willing to take a little risk and run a little further down.
Can you go under
pull my
tree?
Hood?
As you're going down the path, you're following the directions along the side of the mountain, taking a certain number of paces this way, that way, following it down, and eventually you come to a tree where very obviously the roots are like 10 feet in the air above it, like, and then they're digging into the ground beneath. And you can kind of squeeze past them and see a cave beyond.
I would like to go into that cave.
Okay.
Casting light, since she's going first.
On her?
On her.
Okay.
You probably shouldn't be in the front.
No, no, I really shouldn't be.
So,
do we want to change casting light to somebody who's a tank?
I can go in front.
Okay.
Okay, switching.
I'm tank as fuck, so.
Yep.
Tank as fuck.
Whatever the opposite of that is.
I'll stand at the back.
She's my tank girl.
To make sure we don't get ambushed.
I guess I take middle again?
Yeah, because we don't want you doing anything.
Yeah, but like stay firmly middle.
I need a different D20.
Chill.
Here, I'll trade you.
Now, the next question. How many uses did you use on the wand to get us back to full health before we walk in here?
We need to figure that out. How much is everybody down?
How much is everybody down?
Why am I getting shit rolls?
I'm at 3, I think.
I'm at 4.
So
what are we looking for?
I'm just fine.
Caster level for the wand was...
Let's all pay attention to the symbols on the floor right now.
Before we walk in,
we'll figure this part out, and then we'll come back to that.
Yeah.
All right.
12 hit points.
Cool.
Does that bring you up to full, or?
Yeah.
Okay. How much would bring you up to full?
Are these supposed to be walls 11. And then doors?
Yeah, these are doors right here.
So that's 3 uses gone. How much are you down?
I'm at 4 right now. Full is 18 for me.
Okay. Oh, wait. What's that's already 1-6, so... 14
okay.
should bring you to 1 off.
I think it's like a wall.
No, full. You're at 18, right?
I'm at 18, yeah.
Okay, so yeah. So that's 2 more for you.
Okay.
How many did I... How many?
Is that right, marching order?
I mean,
he
13
should be
hit points.
More front than middle.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, but behind the tank.
13 out of 21.
So yeah, there we go.
But he's going to end up here.
Yeah, eventually. But let him be behind the person who can actually take damage from the beginning.
And then I need
2. This is fun. I like this.
All right.
I mean, not this particular. I just really didn't think I was going to like Dungeons and Dragons or role.
Pathfinder? Fantasy RPG?
Yes. That pen thing. And paper fantasy RPG. But I do.
Welcome to our world.
Is everyone healed what they want to be?
Yeah, and we used 8 charges on the wand, so...
Really?
Four people each at single digits? Yeah.
Okay.
All right. The tunnel, not very far down, opens up into a wider antechamber.
Like you're supposed to.
The room is about 40 feet tall inside here, and on the floor are 4 patterns. that you recognize as the slant, the triangle, the square, and the circle. There's corresponding doors in front of those patterns on the floor, and then there's a fifth door in the center of all four of those doors.
So I get the feeling that only people with the shapey eyes can go through the shapey doors.
Or at least
you should get close to the nondescript door, and we should line up on the spots with the thing.
Yeah. Before you do that, I noticed there's something odd about each of these symbols.
Yeah. Can I detect magic on this place?
Use detect magic. Yeah. I can too. Might as well get multiple people looking around.
It seems mechanical in nature.
Okay.
None of us
have trap detection, do we? We don't have a rogue.
Can I use dungeoneering?
Yeah.
Okay.
Knowledge dungeoneering.
Is move a die?
Can I even... Okay, that's a 9.
You were so close. So close.
So there's grooves, so the pattern is made by something in the floor rather than...
Is move diagonal or just straight? Diagonal.
It's 1.5 for diagonal.
Yeah.
So 5... 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Does that make sense?
Sort of.
It's 1.5. So the first one is 5, the second one is 10.
Yep. Okay.
They're 15.
Yeah.
That makes more sense. Okay.
Okay. So yeah, she's a little bit in the room. You guys are all looking around it.
I would like to move to the triangle space.
Okay, you step on the triangle.
Does it make any kind of reaction to you? Nothing?
No.
Can I detect anything else from my triangle space?
Give me a perception check.
With my pink glittery d20. 14.
You notice that the triangle kind of slants downhill to the point where there's a tiny little hole at the end of it.
Can I see anything in the hole?
You reach down and put your eye to it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's dark down there.
I have dark vision. Is there anything down in there?
Doc runs over, crawls over. He doesn't go very far down.
Doc's face.
Way to just cross in a very funny position there.
Starts blowing Hulk, you know.
Hello. Hulk's a lady.
She's not.
Yeah, that's ideal.
So, you look down there and you can see at the bottom of it. It doesn't go too far down. It just spreads out toward, like in a spiderweb pattern, towards this door.
Okay.
But nothing happens when she stands on it.
I'll go look at like the square and circle, see if it does kind of the same thing.
Yep. There's a corner here, and then a hole in this,
and then that one. Slanty bit.
It all slants down to that hole.
It's so face.
Wow.
He's got a look in the hole, right?
He sure does.
I want to walk up directly to my door to see if I can notice anything.
Big square on the door.
Okay.
Can we detect magic on any of these doors?
No locking mechanism of any kind that I can detect? Any
There's no handle.
Jiggle the handle?
No handle. Any magic on the doors?
You're not detecting any magic when you aim it at the doors.
I think I know the answer.
Can I shout over to Anders, tell him to stand on your square, and then I go stand on the circle?
You can share some information here.
I'm going to wait, because I'm not sure if I'm right, and it might hurt people.
So we don't have... We do not have crack, so we can't.
Do I tell them about the fact that crack actually had the slant in his eye?
We know that.
Okay. He read the other book.
Okay.
We saw it in front of us.
You didn't.
Oh, that's true. I didn't know. Everyone else
did. Everyone else knew. And he's not here.
Do you want to check out the last one? The slant one?
Yeah, sure. I will go check out the slant
one. You want to give me a perception check when you're over there?
18.
Yeah. You see at the very end of it, when you feel the groove, it's really slick. Like, it has some kind of waxy coating to it. And at the very end, you're seeing, droplets of blood at the hole.
That's what I thought.
That's what I thought, too.
Yep. So, bleed into those holes. Like a single...
I would like to slit my thumb and put some blood in my hole.
Go ahead and take a point of damage as you
That's fine.
prick yourself.
Same.
Ditto. All three of you guys?
Just
sword, yep. Hand.
So yeah, you take it and you just kind of squeeze the blood down onto there. It dribbles in. You have to hold it for a little bit of just...
To fill the triangle, I gotcha.
It doesn't fill the triangle, but it's enough to get to the
yeah,
hole. Get
yeah,
to
you
the
gotta
door.
Set it to the okay, contraption.
So yeah, you hold it over there, let it pour out for a little bit, and slowly you hear a click, and the door drops down. This one, this one, this one, this one.
I will go through the door.
Okay. The door comes up as soon as you walk through.
Cool.
Look at the middle door.
All right. Perception?
Okay. No, oh, she's in a different room, so I don't think I can take 10. 13. Not good enough.
You don't notice... again, there's no handle on this door or anything like that.
Detect magic on it?
No magic emanating from it.
Is my door open right now?
Yes.
Yep.
Can I cast light just down the hallway?
You need to cast it on something.
On something.
So you can cast it on like a rock or something like that and throw it down the hall.
Okay, we shall do that.
Okay. So yeah, you can see that the hall goes down about this far before it opens up into a larger room down here.
Stay there for a second. I try to go through his door.
Okay. When you go through, the door closes behind you.
Oh.
Way to go.
Well, it gets us two through.
I want to go inspect the middle door.
Okay.
See what I can find about it.
It's the door!
That's the door! I had to have a door, that's a good door.
That's a good door.
Let me tell you nothing about that door, that's a good door.
Alright.
That door?
You just hear coming from the other side, goddamn, that's a door!
Goddamn
door. So I look at these two, I'm like, well, pretty much we can guess what's going to happen if one of us goes through this door. Is there potentially any way we can all try and run?
Well, I think if he puts an, like, either of you put another
droplet
of blood in,
it'll open up.
It'll open up again.
Okay.
So probably have...
Let's have Anders try and actually add a droplet to see if this door...
Yeah, I'll go over to the triangle one and...
Do it on your screen,
do it on your
already
door.
Closed.
Oh, okay.
It's probably keyed to whichever, like, eye symbol you have.
So okay.
He takes another
point. Take another point of damage. Yep. As you reopen the blood and just
straight
squeeze
up
it down in there.
Pirate your
do you do anything when the door closes behind you? You can't hear anything behind you.
I mean, I probably... walk forward like a five, like a little bit, like halfway down the hall. Just stop there.
Get close to the.
You don't like
get
knock
close
on
to
the
light.
Door or anything?
No, because I saw
the
yours
far
close
wall over here.
I can't. I can only see 30 feet ahead of me.
In he's light? In charge.
In anything.
Oh, your oracle?
Yeah.
I hate you.
Wow.
The worst.
you go down a little bit and the door opens behind you.
Okay, then on three we all go through our doors.
Well, I can go through the door again, so you can go through yours. Jira can go through mine and I'll reopen mine again.
Okay, so Jira's going through yours?
Yeah, so mine will close.
Closes up.
And I'll poke myself again to reopen.
Okay.
And then we'll go through his. Yep, we'll walk through our.
And then that brings everyone inside.
Love this.
I hate you.
Yeah.
Hey, Mira.
God damn it!
So the door closes behind you and you're pitch black.
Yeah, it's fine. I will. Can I, like, flint and tinder, like, a fire? Does that happen?
Can you do you have tinder?
You should have a torch and flint and tinder.
Do you have a torch?
Yes. Light? You have an adventurer's kit, so yes.
Yes!
Do.
All right, yeah.
Sure
go
do.
Light up a torch.
Yeah,
yeah.
Torch.
You see that the hall turns right up here.
Told you.
Oh, we split the party.
Yeah, yeah, we did.
Cool.
Big time.
Cool. I go that way.
You go that way?
Oh. Do you just want to peer around the corner?
Yeah, I want to peer around the corner.
Okay, so you see a small circular room up here.
Okay.
And in the center of that room is another triangle.
Oh. Specifically made for me.
Just for you.
just for me. This is going to end poorly, but I would like to explore that room. But before I touch the triangle, I would like to detect magic.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Stop.
You are sensing transmutation magic resonating from that triangle.
Changing stuff.
Yep. And I can't tell what it's changing. No.
The longer walking...
Spellcraft check, okay.
Or knowledge
arcana.
He took
your D20s, they're on Stefan's sheet.
Okay. I was like, I swear I had one. Oh, I don't like yours either. 12.
My It'll dice are assholes
right.
today.
I'm going to touch it.
You going to touch it?
Yeah, I'm going to touch it.
Okay.
You reach over and touch it.
Goodbye.
We're doing it.
You two, in the second hallway, in the square way.
Okay. Venture forth, grab my rock, and
a square way.
Start heading wherever the path leads us.
Yeah,
you get to the end of this room, and there's kind of two diagonal walls at the end. Okay. And in the center of the room is a square.
Okay,
but the room is a rhombus.
This room is a lie.
All squares and rectangles are rhombuses, but not all rhombuses are squares or rectangles.
Let's see. Can I use...
This hurts.
Am I detecting any kind of magic? Do I feel any different? And the closer do I get, do I start feeling that euphoric feeling again, like when I first read the book?
No, but the symbol, like, it's just a square, but at the same time, it seems like it has more meaning than just being a square.
Okay.
Like, that's some nice German right there on the floor. Even though it's just a square.
Can I try dungeoneering again just to investigate?
Also, detect magic.
Detect. For...
And also get closer so I can actually see.
Yes, finally. That is a 22.
22? You're seeing the same grooves in this thing that you saw on the door out here.
Okay.
We need to detect magic. You can see that that square is emanating transmutation magic.
Spellcraft?
Mm-hmm.
Spellcraft's not that great, though.
Hey, I got that.
18. Nothing.
Want me to give her a shot?
You know that it's going to change the person that turns it on.
Okay. So
you don't know what it's going to do, but it's linked to...
I'll give Spellcraft a chance. I'm pretty good there.
Chance on me.
Chance
on me.
That is an 11, unfortunately.
That's a square.
And it's magic.
And you know what you like.
It is going to change you. If you step on it. Or give it blood. Let I don't it know blood, which whatever. It is.
I love how the dog is just holding Superman's butt.
It's like it's just like Superboy.
I'm chasing him down the hog.
You ain't gonna tell me that.
Give him the clams.
I'm adulting
right now.
I'm not gonna
right
tell
now.
You what?
How much? No, I'm just talking.
I've told you all I know.
I know.
I'm actually like an official mentor.
Well, I'm wondering with my other ability that we haven't fully disclosed yet, would this affect that?
It might.
You never know.
You never know. Who wound up with the pocket watch after... No, you got the... Did you get the pocket watch?
No.
You took what was in it. Ring?
Yeah, I took the ring.
Okay. Because I was like...
I gave her the ring because she needed the strength more.
Okay.
Yeah.
Did you know that you had this thing?
No. Okay. I didn't know I had this thing. What
you
is
have
this
a
thing?
Ring of...
bull strength.
Yeah, essentially bull strength. So once per day, I think it is?
Yeah, it's once per day.
You can, as a swift action, cast bull strength on yourself for one round, which gives you +4 to strength, which gives you additional
plus
to hit and damage.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
Good to know.
So if you now. One round really need to hit, it gives you +2 for that round.
As long as I don't fuck up and hit the wall again.
Yeah. I mean, you're less likely to hit the wall when you use it.
When you use it, yeah. Doc, you got my back? Oh, yeah.
Or my front, whichever you prefer.
He's groping
I
it.
I mean, going for the reach round, I guess.
All right, we'll take one more hit point. We'll put some blood in there.
All right, pause. You too.
Well, I have dark vision, so...
Do you have dark vision?
Nope, I'm
so
a human.
So she's feeling around behind you.
I'm totally... Yeah. I
am sorry, I did not mean to grab you there.
I'm sorry again, and again.
Are you letting her hold on to you, or...?
No, he's being a butt.
You being a butt?
Oh, I mean, it's really nice, but...
But...
I guess I'll move forward since I can actually see.
All right. Get to the corner. You see a nice circle in the center of a triangular-shaped room.
That's me.
You see a nice circle in a triangular-shaped room.
Oh, God.
Oh, did you figure it out?
Yep.
Good job. I hate him.
It's going to be hilarious.
I basically relate back to what I'm seeing since I can pretty much tell everything. It's room ahead. It's got another one of the symbols on the floor. I'm probably going to guess it might be just like the one outside, but just in case, let's make sure that we kind of keep an eye out for any traps. So I'll move up a little bit. Can I use any perception to check for anything?
I don't know any better.
19.
Again, you see that groove that you saw on the outside with the hole in the center of it.
Yep. Okay. Do I see anything else around in the room? Or is it just literally that symbol on
just
the floor?
That symbol.
Well, not sure on what our other friends are doing, but I'm pretty sure, knowing Anders, he just stuck his finger in the hole and didn't ask for any other questions.
Probably.
Is he a good point of damage?
Seeing nothing else around the room, and I can't really detect magic for anything. Following suit, since we have to keep going, I'll prick and...
All right. So, yeah, you prick, and you drop some blood. Can I see your character sheet for a second?
You can in 1 second.
Now, you just went and stood on it, right?
Babe.
You. Hi.
Welcome
to the party. You didn't sacrifice blood or anything?
Well, I was trying things out. I was the first person. I will sacrifice blood, but not. I ran out of actions.
But your intention, though, when you went in there? Were you going to drop blood?
Well, I was
going to
see what was happening. But then after I saw what was happening, then my next thing was to sacrifice blood. But I have not yet.
Okay.
Sorry.
So, let me see your character sheet real quick. You step into the triangle and give me a perception check real quick.
7.
Okay. You say that.
I mean, I'm probably still going to get pwned, but also you rolled too. So.
And you're flat-footed. So you hear a gunshot over your shoulder.
Sweet.
Blast a hole in the wall over here. Can you roll initiative for me real quick?
Maybe. Okay. 9.
8 plus, what's your initiative? 5. So, 13.
And 9.
Okay, so he's going to go first with another shot on your back. 14 versus your touch AC.
Is that just my regular AC?
No, you've got...
Touch is below
AC. The same. 13. Win.
Take 12 points of damage.
Oh, Jesus. Why can't you ever roll like that?
I'm not doing anything.
Oh,
awesome.
Blood, drips out of your shoulder and hits
but,
that triangle.
Super not dead.
Super not dead.
There's blood on the triangle.
There is blood on the triangle. Can you two give me perception checks real quick?
Okay.
20.
Anderson and
that is a 4.
All right, you see the halfling come up and try to hit him on the side of the head, but before he hits him, you have a surprise action.
Awesome.
Yep.
What is my? Oh, my CMB is not great. Protect life. Smack him.
Okay.
Smack him with a mace, or a morning star. Morning star. Spiky mace.
Nope. And then he's going to follow through on to you. 21 versus your AC.
That'll hit.
All right. And you're not aware. Can I get another D6?
Oh, God.
Get that wand out.
Yeah.
Not too bad. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points of damage as you just get clocked in the back of the head.
Oh, God. All right, so I'm at 9.
Well, can you also give me a fortitude save?
Oh, fuck.
DC 13.
That's where all the potions went.
10.
10? You are stunned. All right, initiative from everyone in this room.
12.
Oh.
What's my...
What does... Oh, no, it's just those two.
19.
19?
Yep.
17.
All right.
You're not in there.
Above 19?
Oh, that's all.
All right, so, Andres, I'm going to use this for his guy and this for the halfling guy.
I'm at 12.
12. Adzo. Crack. All right. Andres.
All right.
You called him 5 foot step at the diagonal.
You called him crack.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 5 foot step to in front. Like, yeah, do that.
Oh, so we have flanking.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, eventually you'll get it, yeah.
Yeah. I'll have it in my turn. And
all right.
You will have it in a second.
Draw my sword and slice and dice.
Mighty swing.
That is a crit.
Mm-hmm. Roll confirm.
The love of God, confirm.
So what do you have to roll to confirm?
You just roll a second attack.
I have 8 to 20 critical.
DC.
Yeah.
And
what would you roll on your second?
An 8.
Total.
Plus whatever.
Plus your base attack
bonus. Oh, plus, that is, so 9.
Okay, not enough to crit.
But my critical on my sword is 8 through 20.
What is your to hit on your sword?
Your to hit on your sword is plus 3.
Okay, so 12 doesn't beat his AC, so you don't do double damage.
Gotcha.
But you hit no matter what.
Okay, so when you reroll on a crit, you're roll seeing for if you double damage, but if you don't get it, you still do regular damage. Yeah. It's not like a double or nothing situation. Yeah. Okay.
7 points of damage.
7 points of damage.
All right. I'm going to 5 foot step over and smashy, smashy. Facey, facey.
I'm alone.
So I assume I hit
slinger.
A 22?
Yes.
Okay. And D8. And that is 11 damage.
All right. His apparition vanishes.
Cool.
Next is you two. Can you give me a perception check? Can
10.
I grab your character sheet real quick?
Sure.
10?
10.
Yeah, you feel like something appeared near you. Can you give me a perception check as well? Can I get the shock and grass part too?
Sure.
It's per level, right?
Is this yours?
Yeah.
Here, where's the one? You have 2 character sheets you can hand off to him and still keep your own.
20.
Okay.
This looks like me if you need the descriptions.
Yeah,
let's just roll initiative then. You can hear him casting something behind you.
16.
6.
19.
That's you as Jira. And then last is Mel. All right. So Andres is casting and stepping up on you. And he's going to try to deliver Shocking Grass. Since she can't see him, she can't do the attack of opportunity against him. And he's going to roll to try to hit you. Are you wearing any metal?
No.
Or carrying metal?
You have studded leather.
Studded leather. Okay, so yeah.
Okay, so... 26 to hit.
Yeah.
And... let's roll to confirm. Probably doesn't confirm on a 11, right? So that's really good. D6 plus 2 more D6. I need one more. You feel the sword stab into you as you take 12 points of damage. Okay. As lightning surges through your body. All right. Then it is Jira's turn. You see a flash of lightning up ahead of you in the tunnel, and illuminated is Andres stabbing his sword into him.
Okay, so get up and all nice and close and attack the backstabbing bastard.
You're still blinded, but you can still attack the space that you saw him in.
Yeah.
So you'll have minus four.
19.
That's a roll to confirm.
18.
Damn. What's his AC, though?
18 plus 8.
That should be my
AC. Oh, yeah. 7. Yeah, you're fine. Oh. Yeah. So you deal double damage against him.
Eight, 9, 10, 11, 17, 18, 19, 20.
20 damage? Yep. So he disappears.
Why can I have that during a good battle?
Let's go back to you.
Super.
I like this die, though.
Super. Very excited about this.
Black die.
Can I magic missile whatever the fuck's happening in the hallway?
I like it. Where'd you get it?
Yeah.
Right. A couple of dice.
Do you want a magic missile or do you want a ray of frost?
You've
been bragging ray of frost this whole time.
I want to see this ray.
I really
we can't
don't
see
know.
Nothing. She's not with us.
Magic missile, automatic hit.
But lower damage.
Lower damage.
More damage.
D4 plus 1.
First D3. Oh, sorry. I thought it was D6.
Yeah, yep. Ray of frost is a cantrip.
So I feel like magic.
Yeah, no. Destroy him.
I mean, that's probably not going to happen, but... 4.
4 damage? Okay.
Why are you looking at his... Is he like a replica of this guy over here?
What? All right.
Story
then
plots.
It's his turn. He is going to try to pew-pew you.
What?
But misses.
No, pew-pew.
Boom! Another blast over your shoulder.
It's still a standard action for him to reload.
Is it? Because we haven't been doing that until now, so I assumed he had rapid reload.
He has rapid reload, but rapidly reload brings it down from full to standard.
So you should only be attacking every other turn.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
You're fine.
Call that out earlier next time.
No.
No. It's not
you make a mistake.
So in this combat, we're going to keep the person that I've been fighting with and against the entire time. So he's going to shoot every round, and the apparition is going to have some ghost reloading. yeah. Your turn.
Me again?
Mm-hmm.
I magic missile him again. 5.
5?
5 damage.
Alright. He's gonna shoot back at you with a little bit of pew pew. A lot. 20 versus touch.
Yep. That happens.
Yeah. 7 damage.
Dead.
So you fall down and I'm bleeding out. How negative are you?
You did 7 damage?
Yes.
6.
What's your constitution at?
Plus 1.
Okay.
Not too bad, but...
It's not great.
No.
You take, 10 points of damage. No, sorry, 9 points of damage. You were completely defeated, so you go down to 0.
Okay.
I take 10?
Yes. Or 9 points of damage, sorry. That's how much you were dealt before you went down.
Wait. So was it 9 or was it when I took the
you
first
You took
strike?
9 points of damage through your illusion thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So I got 9 points from the illusion. Oh,
wait, so when I shot him... Oh, no. Sorry.
We all did it.
I was being an adult. It's... I got distracted.
Doc! Right.
People were asking me for advice. Like, what do I do as an adult?
What do I do as an adult?
How do I pay my student loans?
So...
You just kind of see me collapse,
I mean,
it is
a 30-foot radius, and it does not care about walls.
You hear the door open behind you. You suddenly see light coming into this room from outside. You're on the ground.
Doors are open?
I'm on the ground, too.
Alright.
Oh, you're on the ground, too?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
9.
Yeah.
How negative are you?
5.
Help.
Did you not get healed?
Right.
I was already at full.
So you reach over his body and start dragging him back.
I haven't been hit the last couple of rounds, but
damn,
he hit me twice.
All right. So, Cure Light, you gives you. I'm just going to get you up and running because I just saw what happened. So I assume other things happened. So take 7 hit points.
Okay.
Are you dragging the body?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna run out the front.
Okay.
And I'm going to follow very tightly behind him, so when 5, that...
10, 15, 20, 25, 30 this way, or this way.
Once I get out, I want to see what's out there, so...
You hear her dragging something, and you see this door open, but you're not hearing anything from over there.
I'm going towards
and
that
this door is also open.
Oh, fuck. I want to stop
him. Don't!
I'm going towards her.
Okay.
The goodliest thing to do. What?
Yes.
Okay. Plus constitution, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ha-ha!
Stable!
Not dying more! Yay!
Okay.
For those listening at home. I got a 19.
Not the thought. Aha! Was a bit of a clue.
You finish dragging him out the rest of the way. You're able to limp your way out with 0 hit points to the thing.
No, you I was at 7 before we left.
Oh, yeah.
So...
So you make it down to the end of the hall, you see her just in a pool of blood on top of the triangle.
Go up to her, and Wand of Cure Light. I'll do 2 charges, because she's real low. That is 9, 5, 14.
Wonderful.
And you're up and running?
Yep.
Nalzim probably is either going to leave that room, or is dead in that room right now, so I'm going.
Yep.
I'm going to make a short stop to...
I was going to say, you're just going to leave Mel just...
Can I run for that room?
Yeah.
I won't make it, but...
15,
20, 25, 30. All right. Can Anders run the other one?
Well, actually...
Okay, he needs to...
No, I'm just going to use a channel right now. So I'll do 1d6 plus 3.
Yeah.
Because that's everybody heals that. So everybody takes 7.
Cool.
You guys are all running down the hallways, and suddenly a burst of healing is spreading everywhere.
How long does sickened last?
Sickened?
That should have ended as soon as we left the shop.
Yes. Yeah.
Have you been taking the -2?
No. That's what I was like, should I have been? Because I haven't been. Spoiler alert.
All right. So...
Yep, runs down to the end of the hall over this way, and you see a water canteen hanging over the room.
Yeah, detect magic.
There's no magic emanating from this anymore.
From the canteen?
From the canteen either. It's dripping this red juice down. Yeah, onto the target.
So, he's up. Anyway, actually grabbing that canteen, how full is it?
About half full. It's been dripping for a while.
Okay, I close it up.
Okay, close it up. This door stays open over here. Yeah.
Let's run out.
Da-da-da.
So
now, let our powers combine.
Right. Yeah. Poor. So, how full is everyone on health?
14.
Full. I'm full.
I'm only down 4.
Okay. You're at 2? You were in range. You should take 7.
Yeah. And that brought me up to 2.
Oh, God. Okay, yeah. We're going to do some things for you. And I'm at 4.
Hi, guys.
What's your max?
19.
Hey, bro.
Anyway. Take 14.
Okay.
And that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 uses off. So, okay. All right, so I assume at this point we have his blood.
Mm-hmm.
So I think if we all pour into that thing at once, we might be able to open that middle door? I don't know.
Yeah.
All right, everyone wants to take a hit point of damage?
Yep, we'll give her a shot.
Sure.
Actually, give me a perception check, everyone, before you do that.
There's something new on the board.
19.
15.
15.
The hole is closed up in the floor. So, like, you know how you have, like, the thing sloping mm-hmm. to a point? It's, that hole is closed at that point right now.
Like there's something pushed onto it, or?
Like, when the doors reset on this side, it closed up that okay. point.
So maybe we shouldn't pour blood into them.
Yeah, these ones probably not. I don't know. Maybe in the other. I don't want to fight more apparitions.
I mean, the doors are closed, so we yeah. can go through them.
They're open.
Can we
right?
check?
Open
right actually, now. Why don't we check the center door again? Like, yeah. try and push it?
So you get too close to the center door. Nothing. Not moving no or anything like that.
Okay.
Well, I mean, I guess it can't hurt to pour blood into the thing.
I'd say into the ones in the separate rooms, though.
It's not going to do any... If I go back through my door, is it going to close behind me?
It does not close behind you.
Okay, then I'm going to walk all the way back down the hallway, and I want to investigate. Is there anything on that square that's still...
The hole's closed up on that square, too.
On that one, okay.
So all of them have closed up, potentially.
I'll go check the slanty one. Does that have a closed up hole?
Yes.
I mean, in the other
room?
In
the other room?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, regroup with the rest.
Yeah.
Share the information.
So we all know now that all of the holes,
the holes are closed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The middle door is still not opening.
Do you go check it out?
Can I detect magic on the middle door?
There's magic emanating from the middle door now.
What are there kind of magic?
Transmutation.
Are there any symbols or anything on the door or like holes?
Yep. Oh. So what wasn't there before and you three can see is like a glowing thing of your symbol specifically. And as you approach it, you can see the circle appearing around the triangle since you guys are
so
close.
So I would like to put my blood on the...
Okay. You go to, like, put your thumb on the triangle, and your hand goes through the door.
I would like to go all the way through the door.
Okay.
I follow with weapon ready.
Okay.
I try and go through the door?
I turn back and I try to have...
Even with the blood?
Are you going to shower in it?
No.
Hey, Doc, give me a hand.
Okay.
I smear my blood on his hand and I have him try to go through the door.
Bunk.
Okay.
I think it's only you three.
I think it's only us. All right, so I follow through the door.
I told you I had a wand.
You can come back and I can give it to you.
You guys enter, like, a pretty small hallway with alcoves along the side of it. Kind of an alcovey thing at the end. And there's altars in each of these concave discs.
I would like to detect magic in the
hallway. No magic resonating in the hallway.
Okay.
And you can see the dust outline on each of the pedestals where some object was.
Can I discern the shape of the object?
One of them was a bracelet, one of them was a ring, one of them was a necklace, and one of them was a shield.
So that must be the band that we're looking
for. The bands we were looking for?
Yep.
Right.
Someone's already been here.
And we know who.
Yeah, we do.
Well, we can only assume.
We can only assume who.
I mean, we know.
They had a canteen of blood.
Yeah.
It might be someone else that took that.
Because technically, if Crack would have came in by himself, there would have been no aberration for him to fight because there's nobody in another room, and
we
were battling
each other. We don't
know that
entirely.
Yeah, we don't know what happens when just one person does it.
We also don't, we don't know if just having one person would make it through all the way, since it took all three of us to open the door, rather than just one.
Anyway.
So, can we perceive anything else in the room, or?
Yep, you're able to pass out the door fine. You're not seeing anything else in there, no.
Okay. Well, head back out.
As you guys pass through the door on your way out, can you each roll me a d6?
D6. Mm-hmm. 5.
2.
5.
All right, take that much in damage.
I knew that was coming.
Yeah, I figured.
And, you feel that at any point in time, you can roll a d6 of damage once per day and gain a spell slot back. So you are able to cast that magic missile that you spent before. Does that make sense?
Wait, what?
You can sacrifice your health to gain a spell slot back.
So I roll a d6 of damage and get a spell slot.
Yes. Okay. Mm-hmm. Same thing for you.
Okay.
And you can essentially expend a d6 to get a grit point back.
Okay. Interesting.
No crap, we're too late.
Oh boy.
Okay.
We want to end it there, or do we want to...
Well, I mean, unless there's anything we want to discuss here at the moment, because we're all kind of in the question phase.
Well, I would just like to share with everybody what just happened in this mysterious hallway.
Okay.
So we went through there. There was 4 alcoves with 4 pedestals with missing artifacts. Probably one of them was the band that we were supposed to find under this...
Okay.
Cave tree.
All I remember is getting stabbed.
And now I mysteriously have a power that allows me to take damage in exchange for spells.
Interesting.
Damn.
But please don't kill me.
But please don't kill me.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I think Crack has been here, or someone has... taken his life force.
His life force?
Someone has the power!
Yeah.
Someone murdered that guy.
Probably.
No more shadow people. Please, no more shadow people.
So.
I hate you.
So, what do we know so far? Somebody's been here. We found a canteen of blood. I battled what looked to be Crack's
a shadow form of
ghost self.
Crack.
oh God.
Grazier is supposedly in prison for
supposedly killing someone.
I would say our next stop would be to go to the prison and find out
what he knows about killing someone and if he knows anything about
most foul.
Yes.
Exactly.
But you will have to wait for our next exciting episode to find out exactly what happens as we once again rejoin our heroes and their faithful quest to find all the magical tomes that they have been touted with searching for. So thank you once again for joining us as the Extreme Hardcore Nerds have presented Roll for Initiative.
Yay!
Thank you for joining us on this edition of Extreme Hardcore Nerds. You will be joining us again next week for our next insightful episode, Kawabunga.